In today's video, I'm going to give you a lot more information about magnesium. Magnesium is one of the most important minerals in our body, and when you watch this show carefully, you will learn much more about health benefits of this important mineral. If you watch the video till the end, I'm going to give you one video that I was making long before about first symptoms that you have magnesium deficiency. So if you're interested in that, watch, of course, video till the end of the show. Magnesium is the fourth most common metal found in the body, with 70% stored in the bones and the teeth. It is needed for the functions of over 300 enzymes and is vital for every major metabolic reaction, from the synthesis of protein and genetic material to the production of energy from glucose. Few enzymes can work without it, and magnesium is known to help maintain health tissues, especially those in the muscles, lung airways, blood vessels and nerves. Lack of magnesium leads to cell death due to depletion of energy stores. One of the most important functions of magnesium is to maintain the integrity of the ion pumps that control flow of the sodium, potassium, calcium, chloride and other salt components across cell membranes. By moving ions against gradients, those pumps allow cells to hold an electrical charge and, in the case of nerve cells, to pass electrical messages from one neuron to another. Magnesium is essential for maintaining cell electrical stability and is especially important in controlling calcium entry into the heart cell to trigger regular heartbeat. And one of the health benefits, of course, if you have a normal magnesium in your food each day, in your body each day, is going to be control of your heart, especially your blood vessels and the normal heartbeat. High blood pressure is the less common in hard water areas where water has high calcium and magnesium content. Can be very helpful for treating high blood pressure in pregnancy, preeclampsia and reducing seizure eclampsia. Second is heart health. Heart attacks are less common in hard water areas where water high calcium and magnesium content. People with low magnesium levels are at the risk of spasm of the coronary arteries, like angina or heart attack, and sudden death due to abnormal heart rhythm. Those effects seem to be more pronounced during the times of the stress. Magnesium treatment has been given immediately after the heart attack to help prevent dangerous abnormal heart rhythms. It helps with widened coronary blood vessels and reduce the formation of palatal blood clots. In the short, that means magnesium has unbelievable important functions for your normal heartbeat, normal heart pressure, prevents the blood clots. What else does magnesium do in our body? Especially is important with diabetes. A meta-analysis of data from 7 studies involving 208,000 people found that those with high intake of magnesium, whether from food or supplements, has a significantly lower risk of developing type 2 diabetes than those with lower intakes. An additional intake of 100 mg magnesium reduced the risk by 15%. Taking magnesium supplements may also improve glucose control or raise good cholesterol levels in people with type 2 diabetes. Fourth is osteoporosis. Magnesium regulates the movement of calcium in and out of the cells. It is important for bone health and prevention of osteoporosis. Women with osteoporosis appear to have significantly lower magnesium levels than similar women without osteoporosis. Taking magnesium supplements for 2 years have been shown significantly increase bone mineral density and prevent bone fracture. That is also one important information that we really need to know. Magnesium can prevent diabetes type 2. Also, it protects your bone. That is especially important in women, middle-aged women and older, that are in very in much cases are in higher risk on getting osteoporosis. That's why you need magnesium. Magnesium also prevents asthma. People with low magnesium levels are more likely to experience spasm of airways leading to asthma attacks. A review of 24 studies involving people with acute asthma found that magnesium therapy, intravenous or nebulized, in addition to bronchodilator drugs, was associated with strong improvement in respiratory function in children, but had only a weak effect in adults. 6 is chronic fatigue. Low levels of red blood cells, magnesium, have a link with chronic fatigue. While early small studies suggested that magnesium could improve tiredness, a lack of energy, other studies have not found significant differences in magnesium level between those people with chronic fatigues and those without. In the short, that means asthma is of course very big problem, especially in the younger people, in the children. Supplementations, or better yet, eating food that has good quality magnesium can help. Also, some people can feel better with this chronic tiredness, chronic fatigue, but not all of them. But usually, if you are the one of the people that are chronically tired each day, and that is one of the symptoms of chronic deficiency of magnesium, maybe you have the beneficial results. 7 is fibromyalgia. Early studies suggested that white blood cells magnesium levels were significantly decreased in people with muscle pain due to fibromyalgia. Later studies have not found significant difference in magnesium levels between people with fibromyalgia or without. Significant increase in magnesium content of platelets have found, however, leading some researchers to suggest that disturbances in calcium-magnesium flow may be involved. Some people find that taking magnesium supplements reduced number of tender points. 8 is PMS. Several studies found that red blood cells magnesium levels are significantly lower in the woman with premenstrual syndrome than those without. Magnesium commonly deficiency is common with 85% of fertile adult female population aged between 19 and 24 years, obtaining less than RNI 270 milligrams daily. That means usually, and that is well where researchers are founded, if you have these painful periods, your menstruation are irregular, you have some kind of problems with PMS, maybe the magnesium can help you a lot. You will not believe it. What else magnesium is best for our body? There is one disease that is called cerebral palsy. Analysis of 6 trials involving almost 4,800 women found that women at-risk partum delivery before 34 weeks gestation were given magnesium sulfate supplements, the risk of cerebral palsy in their offspring was reduced by 31%. This was confirmed in another analysis involving 6,000 babies, which found that magnesium can also reduce muscle control problems. How magnesium protects the brain from the damage that can cause cerebral palsy it is not certain, but may involve improved neuron function or improved blood flow to the brain. Dose: the old EU RDA for the magnesium was 300 mg per day. The newly set EU RDA has increased to 375 mg a day. People who are physically active need more than those are not. A large amount are lost in the sweat. The upper safe limit for the long use supplement suggested 400 mg per day, and usually dose from supplementation is 150 to 375 mg a day, taken with food to optimize absorption. And that is why you need, of course, magnesium had a lot more health benefits, but these are one of the most important. That's why you need to take eat food with a large quantity of magnesium. You will get, of course, better with many other problems, and you also can prevent this problem that I said earlier. Before we continue with the show, I want to recommend you my book that is called Intermittent Fasting, The Secret of Health and Longevity. It's officially on sale in Croatian, English, German and Polish. You can buy the book immediately via mariolab.hr website. Why you should have this book? First of all, you will learn how to properly practice intermittent fasting, which is most powerful tool for preserving your health. My book will teach you how to protect yourself from the cancer, prevent heart attack and stroke, dementia, lose weight naturally, preserve joint health, and much, much more, in perfectly natural way. Don't miss this unique opportunity to learn how intermittent fasting can improve your health and extend your lifespan. If you want to find out what are the main symptoms that you have a chronic lack of deficiency in magnesium, click on on this video and you will learn a lot more. Thank you for following me. See you next time. Bye-bye.